إن الحمد لله نحمده سبحانه ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهد الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفوته من خلقه وحبيبه، قد بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الغمة وجاهد في سبيل دينه حتى أتاه اليقين، فاللهم اجزه عنا وعن والدينا وعن الإسلام والمسلمين خير ما جازيت به نبيًا عن قومه ورسولًا عن أمته. اللهم أحينا على سنته وأمتنا على ملته، واحشرنا تحت لوائه وأوردنا حوضه، واسقنا من يده الشريفة شربة هنيئة لا نظمأ بعدها أبدا. أما بعد، يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. Brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent us the Quran to enlighten us and to give us a light with which we see life and we see people and we see things and we see events and we see beyond what people are always trying to hide from us. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, اتَّقِ فَرَاسَةَ الْمُؤْمِنِ, beware of the intelligence and the insight of the believer. فَإِنَّهُ يَرَى بِنُورِ اللَّهِ, because he sees through the light that Allah has given him. So what is the light that Allah has given us? It is the Quran. Another light is the practice, the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Those are very important for us, not only for anything, but to see how things are, how things should be, and who did what, so that we can fix everything in life the way it should be. We should be fixing and reforming everything in life to meet the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. During these days, while corona is turning wild, more lethal and more faster than ever before, it is unreasonable for us to continue to deny the fact that this is a musibah. It is a catastrophe that is coming upon humanity, and it has already come, and it is increasing its steps forward, achieving its goals, taking more lives, limiting more freedoms, disconnecting most of us from each other, including family members that we love to meet and see. Now the question, the eternal question that humanity needs to look at, but specifically Muslims, if this is from Allah, why? If this is from Allah, how do we deal with it? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in Surah Ali Imran, أَوَلَمَّا أَصَابَتْكُمْ مُصِيبَةٌ قَدْ أَصَابْتُمْ مِثْلَيْهَا قُلْتُمْ أَنَّا هَذَا. And when a catastrophe or a calamity befell you, you ask, where is this from? What is the reason? And the Quran answers saying, قُلْ هُوَ مِنْ عِنْدِ أَنفُسِكُمْ. It is because of what is in yourself. It is of your own doing. In Surah An-Nisa, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَكَيْفَ إِذَا أَصَابَتْهُمْ مُصِيبَةٌ بِمَا قَدَّمَتْ أَيْدِيهِمْ ثُمَّ جَاءُوكَ يَحْلِفُونَ بِاللَّهِ إن أردنا إلا إحسانا وتوفيقا. And how about when they are afflicted with a serious affliction and they come and tell you that we are only doing what we're doing to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and we are only doing it to reform and correct what is going on. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala again tells them that this musibah is because of what your hands has advanced. Everything wrong that happens in this life is because of man's doing. It is not correct that we blame Allah for doing what He told us. If we do not listen to Him, He will interfere and we will not like it and it can be a catastrophe. Humanity is still in denial. And we, the Muslims, need to bring humanity to recognition of the facts. And the facts are no musibah comes without sins. This is the statement of Imam Ali radiallahu anhu arda. ما نزلت مصيبة إلا بذنب ولا رفعت إلا بتوبة. There is no difficulty that comes in without sinfulness. And no difficulty will be lifted up, no relief will come without repentance. So we get the first wave and everybody discounted it. And those of us who spoke that this is a test and it could be a punishment from Allah, they were maligned by everybody. Why? Because we love to have things our way. But this is the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The way of Allah is nothing wrong happens to any human being, individual, family, community, or society. Nothing wrong happens without a sin. So the question is not, why do you Allah do that? The question is, what did we do to deserve? Because the bottom line is, وَمَا كَانَ رَبُّكَ لِيَظْلِمَهُمْ وَلَكِنْ كَانُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ يَظْلِمُونَ. إن الله لا يظلم مثقال ذرة وإن تك حسنة يضاعفها. Allah سبحانه وتعالى does not wrong anyone. So if you become in difficulty, if you run into difficult times, the time is not to question Allah, the time is to question, what did you do? It's a moment for reflection, a moment for review, a moment of truth. Also, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala calls death a musibah. And anything that leads to death is as close to a musibah as it can be. Musibah also means, it comes from the root word sawaba, wasawaba, which means to correct, to divert you from the wrong direction you're heading in. It is like when you're driving in a road and you see a sign saying detour. It is telling you that the right direction is to follow the sign if you want to get where you want. If you insist and continue to do the same thing, you may run in a fire, you may run into an accident, you may run into flood, you may run into a ditch, you will run into trouble. So the more humanity ignores the signs and the messages coming from heaven, the more we continue to run afoul against our own interest. This is what the Quran is saying. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِن تُصِبْكُمْ حَسَنَةٌ تَسُؤُمْ وَإِن تُصِبْكَ مُصِيبَةٌ يَفْرَحُوا بِهَا. If something bad happens to you, they celebrate and rejoice. And if something good happens to you, they are not happy. Those are the enemies of our ummah. They don't want us strong. You see what they are doing with Turkey. You see what they are doing with anyone who stands up for the rights of Islam and Muslims. Siege, sanctions, and boycotting, and everything else. But when we, the Muslims, stand up to defend our prophet, they are crying foul. Why do you boycott us? So the assumption here is they are angels, they deserve no punishment, not from Allah, not from us. What does it mean? It means they are telling us we are the gods on this earth and we must resist this attitude. We must resent this attitude. And the way to do it is to stand for truth no matter what, to speak truth and to do truth and to stand for justice, to stand for the oppressed, for the underprivileged, for those who are not doing as well as the wealthy and the healthy and the big top echelon of societies. Those are on their own. But we, the people, have to stand for truth. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also in Surah Al-Qasas, وَلَوْلَا أَن تُصِيبَهُمْ مُصِيبَةٌ again, بِمَا قَدَّمَتْ أَيْدِيهِمْ, were it not for them to repent out of, this is the treatment, this is the relief from a crisis or a calamity that befall them, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying that it comes from their own hands. Everything that happens on earth is man is doing. We hear a lot of our children asking why there is a lot of calamity. Atheists are teaching our children that if there is God, everything should be angelic, it should be paradise. Justice should prevail on earth. But the answer should be clear and simple. Whatever is happening of calamities or anything else, it is because of what the hands of people have done. What's happening in Yemen is not a divine order. It is human to human. It is injustice. What's happening in Palestine, it is human to human. When people invade other people's land and they want to take it by force to capture the wealth that those people should enjoy, this is a human travesty. And we should stand with those who are not able to stand on their own. This is what we should always look for. Also, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us that He has given opportunities for people to return to Him. He has given opportunities for people to come back to Him. وَأَخَذْنَاهُمْ فَأَخَذْنَاهُمْ بِالْبَأْسَاءِ وَالضَّرَّاءِ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَتَضَرَّعُونَ. We have taken them with calamities and difficulties so that they may come back in humility and submission. That's the purpose. This is the point. The point is to bring us back to Him, to return and say, oh Allah, we repent. We accept your message. We accept your guidance. We accept your prophet. But so long as people insist on driving in the wrong direction and ignoring the detour sign, they will never change course. They will face difficulties more than what they saw in the beginning. This is the sunnah of Allah, and this is the rule of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we need not to continue to deny as if we are angels. We deserve no punishment. We have done nothing wrong. All of these colonial powers that stole all the wealth of Africa, they are still working to redivide Africa and instigate and incite wars between nations in Africa so that they stay safe. This is their theory. But Allah min wara'ihim muhit. Allah knows what they are doing. He knows even not only their plans, but what they have in their hearts and what's hidden inside the core of their heart. Their intention is known to Him. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised. He said, إِنَّهُمْ يَكِيدُونَ كَيْدًا وَأَكِيدُ كَيْدًا فَمَهِّلِ الْكَافِرِينَ أمهلهم رويدا. Don't listen to the press when they say Muslims, Muslim imams are always talking about us versus them, as if we are starting a war. Nobody starts a war from a masjid. Nobody wants violence. Nobody wants aggression. But we are citing the facts, and we are educating ourselves as to what the Quran is telling us about the reality in which they want us to live. We want to create the reality according to the Quran. We want to create a reality that is peaceful for everybody, for Muslims, for Christians, for Jews, for everybody. This is the reality we want. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala open our heart and accept our prayer. الحمد لله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله وصفوته من خلقه وحبيبه اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وصحابته ومن اتبع سنته بإحسان إلى يوم الدين اللهم اهدنا فيمن هديت وعافنا فيمن عافيت وتولنا فيمن توليت وقنا واصرف عنا شر ما قضيت اللهم اقسم لنا من خشيتك ما تحول به بيننا وبين معصيتك ومن طاعتك ما تبلغنا به جنتك اللهم إنا نسألك من الخير كله عاجله وآجله ما علمنا منه وما لم نعلم ونعوذ بك من الشر كله ما علمنا منه وما لم نعلم يا رب اغفر لنا ولإخواننا الذين سبقونا بالإيمان ربنا ولا تجعل في قلوبنا غلا للذين آمنوا ربنا إنك رؤوف رحيم وأقم الصلاة